Hi, would you like to enhance your models and projects with LED and laser lighting effects? Hi, my name's Jeff Dregg. I'm an electrical engineer, and I design and work with LED lighting and laser lighting effects. In this video are just a few of the many projects that I've designed and built laser lighting effects, LED lighting effects, and sound effects into. The last two segments of this video is a very large, 4-foot, Starship that I designed and built. It's been in several magazines and on TV. If you care to get in touch with me, send me an email. My email address is buildingultimatemodels@gmail.com.
Danger, danger, Will Robinson!
I computed the aliens. They are capable of sinister and dangerous acts.
Alright, this is a back-and-forth flasher. And I'll put these lights in the torso right here.
My programming is infallible. The function of any computer is to draw conclusions from provided data. If conclusions are contradictory, provided data is at fault. That does not compute. Programming data insufficient. My micromechanism thanks you. My computer tapes thank you. And I thank you.
Is what makes time travel possible. The flux capacitor. I got a new toy to show you.
Wow, I can't wait. Oh my gosh, that's incredible.
We'll be right back.
adventures in the air that bunk 40,000 years and grizzly goons from every kingdom are closing in to steal your doom. And though you fight them to stay alive, your body starts to shiver.
When professional model maker Jeff Tregg takes on a project, he combines years of model building experience with his electrical engineering know-how to create what can only be described as ultimate models. Here's a look.
The Dallas Crown Plaza Hotel was home to FinCon, the annual science fiction and fantasy literary and music convention created by fans for fans in the DFW area. The conference attracts writers, artists, musicians. This year, one of the things they'll want to see is the display by professional model maker Jeff Tregg. The 4-foot model of the Starship Enterprise is Tregg's own design, a product of many hours of research and then more hours of adapting a variety of different model kits to fit his blueprint.
I gathered a ton of information. And I had collected it, photos from the movie. I downloaded the movie. I downloaded sections of just the video of the Enterprise so I could see it frame by frame by frame. I bought several different models and smaller ones, and I incorporated some of the parts into this one as well.
But the feature that sets Tregg's work apart from the crowd is the LED lighting features that he designs and engineers for his projects.
I'm a professional model builder as well as electrical engineer, but I wanted something to where I could put the electronics, get all the electronics and the lighting effects into it as well, and I've done so with this 4-foot Enterprise.
The results are really spectacular. Tregg has kept the integrity of the Starship design, but added a few enhancements.
I've added on quite a few extra LEDs and lighting effects that don't normally exist on the motion picture model. But I like them, and since I'm the captain of my Enterprise, I can do that.
His attention to the smallest of details truly shows that he's built an ultimate model.
Well, there's different aspects and parts of the Enterprise. For example, this is the Botanical Gardens, and if you look inside the window here, you can actually see all the gardens and the fountains and the lakes and everything, the little walkways that they use for recreation. One thing I love so much about the original Star Trek Enterprise was the swirling red glowing lights that you saw on the warp engine nacelles.
Sure.
And this Enterprise didn't have that. So basically what I did, using electronics, I basically simulated, instead of on the front, I did on either side. And then on the front area here, we've got the deflector array sensor. And it's got a starburst effect. Okay, so you're seeing several surface mount LEDs go into a starburst at different frequencies. And then in the very front here is the photon torpedoes. and each one will basically charge up and fire.
That is.
And then this piece that you see here is the deflector shield, and it basically recycles about every 10 minutes or so. It stays on for 2 minutes, cuts off, and then they'll raise shields again in about another 10 minutes later.
Jeff also shared some of his ideas in a seminar at FinCon and showed how even a novice can jump right in.
Can I just tell you that this looks like Klingon to me?
Well, that's okay. Electronics is kind of like a road map. So
okay.
What you're looking at, here's the road map, and this is what the here's a schematic, and this is what the component actually looks like. And then this is how to use it. This is what it does. And I briefly tell people, show them how to do this step by step of the way.
Well, that's not so intimidating.
No.
Not intimidating, but definitely impressive. A fact not wasted on the crowd at FinCon.
So what do y'all think?
I love it.
That's the kind of response Jeff hopes his enterprise will bring.
Seeing people's faces, and when they walk up to the model and their mouth just drops. Did you build this? Like, yep. And then they'll ask all kind of questions. Well, how can I build one? Or how did you do this?
And Jeff, ready with his manual, is happy to answer, boldly taking others where no model has gone before. This is Kathy Whiteman reporting.
Welcome to USS Enterprise NCC-1701, which achieved its legendary fame under the command of Captain James Tiberius Kirk.
Resistance is futile.
Lock phasers on target and await my command.
Phasers locked.
Torpedoes ready, sir.
Fire.